Hello then, folks. Welcome back to the final episode. It probably seems a bit weird to be doing an actual episode after the amount of live streams we've done. Sorry if you've missed the summary videos to those. This is a story of the save thing, really. If you missed the final live stream, it's worth going back and having a watch, actually. Well, it was an emotional time. It was an enjoyable time. And I've claimed Manager of the Year as a result of all of it. We won the Premier League. We gunned for it towards the end. And from Boston boy to the hero, to the villain, to gunning for it, we finally got ourselves a league title with Arsenal. So that's good news. Well done to us at long last. And my career as a manager has been, well, underwhelming. You can see across everything that the longest time at a club was 2,717 days. Our shortest time, 1,500. So that's a good 5 years. We spent a long time anywhere. I say that that's the amount of days. It can't be 5 years. It must be around 4 years. Because our shortest time as manager surely is here at Arsenal, you would assume. With three club manager roles, 119 players brought in, a transfer net spend of just 60 million, which I think is not too bad, really. Randy Deckers really was the factor in that. It would have been quite even if it wasn't for Randy Deckers. 100 million. A lot of money to spend. 72 million have gone to agents, so, you know, keeping people in work, in jobs, that's not too bad. A 53% win percentage is not too bad. At Arsenal, of course, it was slightly better. At Villa and Boston towards the end, not so good. I'll say that towards the end, at the start, it wasn't so good, was it? Let's face it. And 2 days on holiday, which is very infuriating for me, just because I got stuck in a couple of menu screens, which allowed me to do nothing but holiday to continue through. If we look through Salford, Palmer, and Thames, I pride myself on the fact I have no holiday days. So the fact I've got two, very annoying, viewers. I mean, I'm more annoyed than anyone else would ever be, believe me. This is poor, isn't it? Over my career, one cup victory, three league titles. I think one with Boston, one with Villa, and one with Arsenal, actually. I didn't think about that. So that's actually quite nice, isn't it, in a weird way. Four promotions and one relegation. The relegation, not really my fault, I don't think, anyway. But yeah, of course, let's go then. Let's take a look through at the teams we've been at and relive some of the good times. So Boston currently are 11th in League 2. That's where they finished things up. Benjamin Stambouli is their manager now. Let's take a look. Who managed past me? If you get rid of the caretakers, you can see that I was there for 7 years, 160 days, a very long time. Harry Ross, Sol Bakken, a name that you're probably familiar with. Simon Francis, of course, the Bournemouth defender. But none of them really doing quite as well as I did. 58%. So that's not me. Please go to me. It's just give me Stambouli. No one cares about what Stambouli's done. Okay, well, apparently he's doing quite a good job, actually. 58% win percentage isn't too bad. To go back, all the way back to the very beginning, that first year, the Millennium Baby, of course. Andy Tannoy was there. George Smith, I spent quite a long time with us as well. Oxlade Chamberlain, who was brought in, I believe. Jordan Slough scored some absolute screamers, didn't he? As we progress a little further, sort of 3 or 4 years in, there he is, Marky Fletcher, the man of the series. One final time, Benny boy. Hit the music. Da-da-da. It's Marky Fletcher. He's having a lovely time. He's in Australia, Sydney, still doing wonderful things. Actually, having one of his best seasons for a long time, but you can see, prolific for a number of years under me. £500, the best £500 I ever spent. Marky Fletcher was the man of this save, really, wasn't he? If it was still a best 11, stay tuned, then he would almost certainly be in it. But again, this was a team that I think a lot of you actually remembered and probably fell in love with. George Penny was there, of course. Alabayusu was an absolute star forward, retired at 27, very disappointing. Ike Opozo, still playing at 31, was a key part of our side. Johnny Byrne there, of course. Callum Burton, lots of familiar names. So we left a couple of years after that, of course. Rob France still there. McCarthy Gribben, Callum Gribben came in. Bigory Manor, he was a star for me. I really, really enjoyed having Bigory Manor. He was, he goes down as one of my sort of cult favourite players in all of this. He was really, really good. As I went a little further along, I think Joe Gelhardt was ours as well. There was a point, of course, when it wasn't our team. I think this was becoming around that point. And then all of a sudden, the team is vastly different. I think this was one of the years, especially though we weren't there, where they started to change things around a little bit. And that then left us then moving over to Aston Villa, from hero to villain. Still very proud of that title, to be honest. Lloyd Morgan, captain. You'd love to see that, really, don't you? Let's look at the best 11 then and go, when did I join? I can't remember. It was around 2027, 28. I feel like it was around there somewhere. Let's see here. Lemons was there. Goodmanson. So I guess this was maybe the season they maybe went down that year. I think that would probably make sense, right? That was the year they went down. This was the first year I took over in the Championship. Yes, you can see it there. And that was a side, wasn't it? Degard de Gaulle. Beautiful to see him. The spelling of his name I've written somewhere and got so wrong, it's unbelievable. But yeah, he was the keeper, of course. Lord Morgan, CS, who we now know, everyone, he's a very good defender at Leicester. So I'm sure we'll see more of him in the future. Batista Mendy, absolute hero for me in those early years. Jack Hurst, very good. Hurtado, we liked the Hurtado a lot, didn't we? And the Rod as well. Do you know what? I'd forgot the Rod existed. But yeah, the Rod at Sunderland at the moment, joining Stoke, apparently. At some point too, when life gives you goals, when life gives you lemons, lemons gives you goals. I got it wrong somehow. What a season he had! He's in America now. Went to Charlton, but yeah, that season in the Championship, 22 goals, 39 appearances. For some reason, I've got a lot of affinity towards Lemons, mainly because of the phrase potentially. And Sisto had a phenomenal year that year as well. And as we went forward in years, Chambers came in. You all doubted him, or like 10 of you doubted him, and I made a massive thing of it. Nestor Rodriguez was a star in that one. Jonovic and Hurtado were a force to be reckoned with. In the centre, Doku, Gwimmel came in, of course, as well. Before Paul Pogba joined us for a short period, amongst other names in there, Meneses, Dusek, Gudmundsson. I think you can't really go too far without mentioning him. He was fantastic. Free transfer. We picked up a couple of frees. I think Paulo Riva was the other guy we picked up. But of course, we got to a point with this side where it wasn't nearly good enough. This was the season without me. So we had to move on to Arsenal for a couple of years to try and get ourselves over the line. And eventually we did just that. I think we were there for, what, 2 years? That's ridiculous. I love that that becomes the system. So yeah, that was the year before me, I think. Although it looks very similar to a side that I had, but I do believe that was the year before me. So this was my first season. Played the Diamonds. Yeah, and Davi up front. Lahaida just behind for Brice Huseman-Koosman. That sounds fun to say. Gibb, Chesney, De Ligt, Lashley and Gentile were in goal. Of course, for Boda here as well, that we'd had at previous teams. It wasn't quite enough in terms of goal scoring. So we move forward one more year. And this was the system. Hopefully you kept up a little bit with the series. So you saw me using this. You can see goals for the front five there. Pretty ridiculous. And Oliveira as well, another player, attacking midfielder, getting himself in the goals, as did Christian Herrera, who's not in the starting 11. But Sandua, Lahaida, Randy Deckers, Reece Nelson and Boris ND. Superstars, the lot of them. And yeah, as you can see, top of the Premier League table. That's a way to end things. 90 points, only 4 defeats. Using the system that I used. Pretty ridiculous, all things considered. I'll be putting this save available for download. I might have versions of Boston, if people would like to play a little bit of that, or at least look through it, or maybe Villa as well. But if you're a Patreon, of course, if you're at a certain tier, then you get this save file to play or look at your leisure if you wish to. Worth noting as well, over on Patreon, if you are a Patreon at any level, I'm doing blog posts still. I did a recent one yesterday, talking a little bit about my year on Football Manager. It's been a strange year. I think for a lot of people that have watched, it's been the most, I guess, tumultuous. Is that the word you would use for this? It's been up and down. It started weirdly for me, doing the Dortmund beta save, and I wasn't overly happy with it, and we did Liverpool after that. And the whole year never really got started for me the whole time. And even when we went to Boston, it became very quickly at Boston that, well, of course, I'm missing out Central Park Rangers there, that I thought was going to be this great save for me. It was a slow starter, but as I was ready to go full throttle, of course, I did the video where I lost everything on my computer, which yeah, put a spanner in the works, it's fair to say. AFC Wimbledon suffered as a result, as did Central Park Rangers. They're both lost. And 2019 feels a little bit like the year of Football Manager that I won't talk about quite as much as I probably will other years. I look back at things like Thames and Salford and Palmer and all these other saves, Spal and Roadtrip and all these, and you know, there's something about each one that I can hang my hat on. And this year, we've got Marky Fletcher, don't get me wrong, and that's great that he's still like a figurehead of this save, and we've got a jingle, you know, based around him, which is quite cool, but it never really clicked for me. And what actually has allowed me to do in the last couple of days, last couple of weeks, is I've been able to look back at this year and realise that it's not really been good enough, not just from, you know, a video-making standpoint, but from a productivity standpoint and from a wanting to be better and try harder. And there was a lack of motivation midway through the year, and I won't put it entirely down to me losing stuff. There was just things going on in my own life, personally and professionally, that were making things difficult. And now I feel like actually I've been able to look at all that and take that and think, do you know what? I'm so much better than this. And there's a reason that a lot of you started watching in the last few years, or maybe you've picked up this year. If you've come this year, I hope you're going to be wowed during FM20. And if you were watching previous to that, I hope you think, do you know what? Yeah, he's fucking back. Bleep that, Ben, for heaven's sake. But yeah, it's been a tricky year, and I'm going to work harder. My promise to you, like, is I'm going to work harder than anyone else creating Football Manager content going into next year. That's something I used to pride myself on, and I feel like in this last 12 months, that slipped away a little bit, and I'm I'm not happy with it, so hopefully you'll reap the benefits, as will I. Like, I want to make good stuff. I want people to talk about saves in the way that they do with the previous ones that have been good. I think Glory Hunter is set up to be really, really fun and really good, and I like the idea of being at a top club continually and fighting my way towards trophies and titles with that time limit of 20 years in place. If you're unfamiliar, check out my plans for FM20, although we'll probably talk about them more in the upcoming days. Look, there's quite a long time. Football Manager have released, the game will come out on the 19th of November. It's their latest release ever. Football Manager have never released a game later than this. And I finished this save a little bit because it was like, well, there's no time left. I've got to do something. The beta, of course, will come out roughly 2 weeks before. There is no official date on the beta. If you ask me about that on Twitter or wherever, I don't know the answer. It's roughly 2 weeks before. It's always roughly 2 weeks before. It changes year on year. There's no set time or date. Anyone claiming they know is lying. there's not much more I can say about that. So, look, for the next week or so, I'm going to take a break. If you remember last year, we finished Thames and I wasn't happy with it. I look back now and think I should have carried on Thames and carried on with it. Look, we started with a tricky year. We ended relatively strong, I thought. Actually, the streams towards the end are really fun for me. I got a lot out of it. And going into next year, I think it's a nice setup to what we can do, and hopefully you'll join me on that adventure. Before we go, one more thing to talk about in regards to this. If I just pull up my splash screen that I use here, like you can see for streaming, Degard de Gaulle just got his name reevaluated apparently, but this would be my best 11, or my favourite 11, crossed with my best 11, Lloyd Morgan, Batista Mendy, minivan, of course, that we had at Boston, right back, Biggie Manor, Alabiusu, Hurtado, Chambers, because you all wrote him off, sort of. Randy, Deckers, and Lemons and Fletcher, of course, up there as well. Probably in sort of a 3-4-1-2 formation, if you get what I'm saying. But that's going to wrap things up for me, folks. Thank you so much for sticking with me this year. I'm hoping next year will be bigger and far better. I've got a Football Manager tournament planned, which should be on a scale that we've not seen before, especially on YouTube. And yeah, hopefully you're looking forward to the journey. The Spurs beta starts on the day in which the beta is released. As you know, I don't know when that is. So when you hear about it being released, look out for that Spurs save. It'll be up at 5 o'clock on that day, I would imagine. And in terms of Glory Hunter, that will start on the 19th of November. That will start on the official release date for Football Manager. So yeah, something to be excited about. November, it's just starting, but well, it's not starting at all. It's still October, but it's coming soon. If you enjoyed this video and this little rundown, little look back through the years, do leave a like. If you want to see some more, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And FM20 is set to be good. And thank you again for your support during FM19. I'll see you soon. We love with care. Goodbye.